the house was just full of people that lived there that were not us.
I was 11 years old when my mother found the farm. And we arrived in the middle of a snowstorm. We were just moving into a charming, lovely, old house, as far as all of us were concerned.
Nancy and I were sharing a room, Andrea had her room, and Cindy and April would share a room. And it was boom, boom, boom. It was pretty much everything was the same way, but it was gonna move to this big new house with this really great big yard. Wham, wham, the bedroom door start flying open out of nowhere, out of absolute nowhere. Wham, bam, up against the sides of the walls, and it would be, everybody would be just in total shock, and we'd be, okay, who did that?
No one was thinking in terms of, oh, the house is haunted and it's freaking the animals out. None of us had even conceptualized the possibility of this, including my parents. I don't think anyone debates that The Conjuring was an excellent movie for what it was, but it barely scratched the surface of our story. And I think it's important that we set the record straight as a family and we divulge the full details, the facts behind the case, the events that occurred at the house. It did capture elements of our story, but there is so much more story to tell.
There's an entity that approached my mother and wanted my mother out of that home. And the way the apparition approached her by her bedside and the way she described her, that her head was hung to one side and looked like a hornet's nest.
I opened my eyes and standing at the foot of my bed.
Was this horrible apparition some kind of specter?
But she went on to say, if you don't leave, you will join us because she too will be dead.
I really didn't realize what was going on until Mrs. John Arnold came to me one day in the basement. And I knew then that there was something. When you're standing there and somebody runs their hand against your back and you turn around and there's nothing there, you realize that there is something going on.
And I just attribute that to the woman that was in her 90s that hung herself in the barn.
We had everything. So I was up there and I was just playing with the little people. And the door from the middle closet opened. And I thought, I just assumed one of my sisters was gonna bounce right through that door. But instead, a woman came floating through. And she had her head tilted to one side, just a little bit. And she came floating towards me. And the words that I heard were, come to me, little girl.
And all of a sudden, on the wall to the right of us appeared a lion. And it let out this huge roar. And we all dropped the Ouija board and we ran down the stairs into the kitchen and we were screaming.
And we would hear her. We would hear her cry. We would hear her cry at night. We heard her cry.
Both were being attacked. The mannequins were coming at them and that's why they were screaming.
I think we fought it tooth and nail for a long time and then I guess we know who won, don't we? Because we know who left and who's still there.
Reflecting about it after it was over, I didn't feel that spirits were really capable of doing physical harm to you. But I was wrong about that. I was wrong about that. There was real danger there.